episode 2238. Are you ready to live?
Moms, it's time to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew who you are in mind, body, and spirit. Welcome to Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, the show to help you do just that. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo.
Staring at a stop sign, watching people drive by.
Happy, happy day. I hope you're having a splendid week. Take a deep breath. You are midweek. You're almost to the weekend. And guess what? March is around the corner. Yes. But you know what? To get there, you got to live healthy. It's Wellness Wednesday. Are you ready to live? For those of you who are brand new to Create Your Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you haven't had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com, where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple strategy, everyday solutions to live, love, and impact. Well, this episode is brought to you by the AIM Academy. And like I said, mark my word, I promise AIM is happening this March. It is going to be exciting and you want to be there. Also, make sure you're signed up for the newsletter. The newsletter is starting out brand new. Yes, we're bringing in spring with a new flair. So you want to stay tuned. You know, major decisions are made every day. However, we seem to miss the decisions that are most important to our health and well-being. Are you ready to live? We settle for less when we can have so much more. Most of us are living for only a moment, not with the hope of what tomorrow will bring. We sit here and look at this as, well, this is what I want to do right now. It's the moment, right? I'm living the moment. And yes, moments are important. But when it comes to longevity and your health, the question remains, are you ready to live? Now, please understand me and understand my heart and where this comes from. This is stuff that I have wrestled with personally. This episode is also dedicated to my dad. You see, we lost him 9 years ago yesterday. There's not a day that doesn't go by that I don't think about him. You see, because he taught me how to live life to the fullest. He made sure that he saw everybody in his path. And that's truly my mission. I want you to know that I see not only you, but I see and hear your heart. And that's really why I want to pose this question. Are you ready to live? Because you see, most of us are ready to die. And not to die where you'll be buried 6 feet under or placed in a wall 12 inches in. You're ready to die because we haven't made the decisions to live. So the question remains, are you ready to live? If you're one who is battling their health right now, if you're one who is struggling to lose weight, if you're one who is caught between making a choice that's better for the body or sitting on a couch and binge watching more Netflix or YouTube, what if you asked yourself the question at that moment, are you ready to live? Am I ready to live? How would that begin to change the self-talk within you? You know, the mind, the thing between your two ears? You see, most of us are caught up in our indulgences. We are tempted by fast food smells, immediate gratification, social media ads that are alluring to what we wish we were. But what about the now? We look at online catalogs, join clubs, buy into things that we think will be the simple pill to answer what we've been facing for months to years to sometimes decades. But it all starts with, are you ready to live? In the Bible, and you can find this in John chapter 5, there was a time when Jesus approached a man lying by a pool. And at this pool, it was known that after the water was stirred, the one who entered first would be healed. Well, Jesus approached this man, and this man had been waiting for 38 years. Not just a couple of weeks, but 38 years. I don't know how old you are, but I know how old I am. I don't know that I've waited for anything for 38 years. But you see, Jesus asked a simple question. Do you want to be well? Notice how it's a closed-ended question, only a yes or no answer. What if you were approached by Jesus today? Are you ready to live? How would you answer? Most of us would run to our maybe answer. We'd be quick to justify because it's easier for us to justify where we are than it is to make a change. Let's be real here. Understand, I've wrestled with this stuff because I know this all too well. As a mom of five, I justified why I couldn't work out. I justified why I ate so late. I justified everything that I could and could not do. I even justified it by saying, oh, I'm doing good work in the community. I'm taking care of the people at church. I'm raising up children to follow God. I mean, seriously, when I say I justified it, oh, I justified it. It costs me a lot of things too. Do you find yourself in justification? Because the question still comes down to a simple yes or no. Are you ready to live? I've been approached many, many times with people asking me, how do you have all this energy within you? Because you see, I was doing all of these things, and I'm still doing a lot of things. I'm just doing things a little bit differently. My children are older, so I'm involved in different things. But I have all this energy, even at my age. And they would sit there and say, oh my gosh, if I could just bottle that up. I'm like, yeah. They're like, you'd be a millionaire. I'm like, yeah, that'd be nice. But I don't know how I can bottle this up. It's just what I have. So what if I had that magic potion? What if I had that magic pill? Would you be ready to take it? Would you be willing to follow the directions? Or would you have to justify? Would you have to justify the finances around it? Would you have to justify how you took it? You see, people want the easy answer, but easy answers require a cost. Jesus asked the man at the pool, do you want to get well? Do you? Are you ready to live? Are you ready to do what it takes in order for you to have the life you desire? Are you tired of going into that closet, looking at all those clothes and saying, oh my gosh, spring and then summer's coming and I don't know what I'm going to wear. Maybe you've got an event coming up for spring break and you're still sitting there scratching your head going, I need to go shopping. Maybe we're looking for all the wrong answers in all the wrong places. I must say answering this question can be twofold. It can lead you down a path of justification, of gratitude. A path of wonderment, a path of questioning. Because you see, your answer is the beginning of your story. The story of where everything changes. It all comes down to, is the pain greater than the reward? Or is the reward greater than the pain? You have a choice every day. When you are faced with choices and not justification, you get to take what you need today. That is your KISS to Keep It Simple strategy. Take what you need today. Sound too familiar? Yeah, it was yesterday's episode. But you see, today is now. Create your now. So take what you need today. If you're ready to live, what does that look like and where do you start? Number one, it all starts with you. Y-O-U. You see, I can give you all the answers you want, but until you recognize that you have to be willing, nothing will change. You got to be willing to do it. And that's a hard realization. We have to look at it if you're realizing your potential or are you justifying your existence? Think about that for a moment. Are you looking at it as if you're realizing your potential? Or are you justifying your existence? It starts with you. Number two, the question becomes, what do you need more of? Do you need to drink more? And we're talking water here. Not those other kind of drinks. Water. Straight old H2O. Do you need to be eating less? Maybe you need to be eating more. Maybe you need to be eating differently. Do you need to be moving more intentionally? Do you need to just to get up and walk and move the body? Do you need to have somebody in your life to encourage you? Maybe the people you're hanging out with aren't really feeding the life that you desire. This is not a trick question. What do you need more of? You know the answer. And finally, number three, you have to be intentional and take aim. Action ignites motivation. Nothing comes with ease. All of it comes with hard work, commitment, and dedication of oneself. But you've got to take aim. Motivation doesn't come until you put what? Action behind it. Action ignites motivation. That first time that you go out and walk, even if it's just around the block, and you come back in the rest of your day, you're like, wow, I didn't actually feel real tired. I thought I would be. What do you think that does for you for the next day? I felt pretty good. So you wake up and you're like, oh, I don't want to walk, but man, I do remember I felt really good. Great, let's go two times around the block this time. Oh, that's feeling awesome. I'm beginning to sleep better. Then pretty soon you put on these nice little leggings that you thought, oh, you know, I like them because they fit me regardless of the size that I am. Uh-huh, we know that. But this time you put them on, you're like, oh, I just washed these and they're a little loose. Action ignites motivation, but you see, it takes action. You have to take aim. Take what you need today. You see, my dad was always one who made sure he gave to everyone every day. But he also took to heart what he needed. Are you doing that today? Are you taking to heart what you need to take out of today? Because the question remains, are you ready to live? I pray that your answer is yes. And even if it's a yes, understand, it's still going to be tough. I know, I'm in the middle of it. Yeah, you're going to fall down. That's okay. You're going to get a few bruises. That's okay. Are you going to do everything right? No, but that's okay. Because guess what? You've chosen to live every single day. Go out, train for life. Love your journey. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. I love you, Dad. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.